try to circumvent what's written, but you can't get around God's word. And so high you can't go over it. And so low you can't go under it. And so wide you can't go around it. You must come in at the door. You must come in by the right, the hand right of God.
Yes.
And you know, we see and hear all of these things that's happening. We talk about bad things that's happening. Let me tell you something. Things are going to happen.
Yes, they are.
I don't know why. I'm not that smart, but one thing I do know, what is written is going to happen.
Yes.
There's another verse that said, if he spared not his own son, what do you think he's going to do for you? But it didn't stop there. There's another scripture there that said, even those angels that was in heaven that fell from the faith, they was cast out into hell. And do you think he's going to do all of that to them and then turn around and look at us and say, oh, you all right. We're not going to send you that way. But I got news for you. If we don't obey the word of God in hell, we lift up our eyes.
Yes.
And you know, sometimes people try to say things to make things different, but you can't change it. It's written. You can take this piece of paper from me. You can even take this Bible from me. But it's written. And thank be to God, I don't have to worry about if you take the paper because it's written in my heart, in my mind.
Yeah.
I know that God is going to do what he said he would do.
Yeah.
It's written. He's telling us, despite all of the mean things that's going on, all the little children that's being kidnapped and left on the side of the road, and the children kidnapped and kept for 10 years in a house and finally get relieved. All of these things going to happen, and when they're happening, instead of us turning to God, we turn on one another. Help me, Holy Ghost. Listen. This thing is getting close.
Yes, it is.
It's getting close. And if the end don't come tomorrow, if the end does not come today, it's still coming.
Amen.
And the reason I know it's coming is written.
It's written.
And you can take all the Bibles, and you know, Festus tried to do that at one time. He gathered up the Bibles to burn them up. But somehow they sprung up somewhere else. Said, where did these come from? And he took those, and then they went in a cave, and they found it written in the cave. Said, Jesus is coming. And he came like he said he would. People say now, oh, the pastor's just trying to scare you. Well, thanks be to God. I began reading this Bible. Not just reading it, but I began to accept it. And when I accepted it, it scared the hell out of me. And if it don't scare you, you must not be reading. Because it's written.
Yes.
And that there's nothing that I can do about it. There's nothing that you can do about it. And the Bible says, fear the Lord.
Fear the Lord.
Fear the Lord. Because he has the power of life and death.
Yes.
In his written word. We wonder why families turn on family.
Well.
We wonder why we can't keep friends too long.
Well.
All you have to do is look in your Bible and say, it's written. Mm-hmm. These things are going to happen. But he also gave us a solution for them.
Yes.
If you trust in him.
Well.
We go around and we talk about racial issues and all that. God didn't make but one race.
Mm-hmm. Human race.
That's all. That's it. There ain't no other race. The human race. That's the only race he had. But like a flower garden.
Yes.
With different colors.
Right.
Yes.
Different heights and different sizes.
Yes.
But it's only one race.
Yes.
And if we trust him, out of all of that confusion, he'll bring it to fruition where we will understand. And I like the way the old church used to say, you know, sometimes I think we got along better when we didn't read too well. They will sing bad and bad.
Bad and bad.
When the morning comes.
When the morning comes.
When all of God's children go heaven home.
Yes, sir.
I don't know when, but one thing
bad,
I know.
Bad and bad.
It's written. Home. But he wouldn't die.
Wow.
He stopped and said, no man, take my life.
Yeah.